everybody! This is Hillary, and I am the Fossil Lab Manager at the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. And today, I'm really excited to get the chance to talk to you about what a fossil preparator is, what the different types of tools that we use, and how I got started, and even how you can be a fossil preparator if you have the time and the enthusiasm to do so. So, find a comfortable seat, and let's get started!
Hey, Took, do you even know what a fossil preparator is? A fossil preparator is someone whose job it is to get those fossils cleaned and prepared, even after they've been out in the field for a long time. By prepping out fossils, they get them ready to be put in the museum's collections or to be eventually put on display for you to come and visit and see for yourself. Pretty cool, huh?
So, are you telling me that fossils don't come out of the ground ready to go and beautiful to be put on display right away? No, silly. In fact, fossils, like dinosaur bones, actually come out of the ground pretty much still covered in rock, and sometimes they can even be broken. It's not anyone's fault that they're that way, it's just how fossils work. So preparators actually use a lot of different tools to slowly get those rocks away and clean them up and glue them back together. One such tool is very special to a preparator. It's called the air scribe, and it's like a mini jackhammer. Wow, I am so glad that I know that information. Thank you very much. You're welcome.
In fact, some of the tools that we use, you may even recognize, like the toothbrush here. We actually use toothbrush to remove softer rock from certain fossils. So something like this is actually a really great tool for fossil preparation. The next time you're brushing your teeth, like I'm doing, you actually are using a fossil preparation skill. How wild is that?
And with all of these different types of tools that fossil preparators have to use, it means that preparators are actually really skilled at a lot of different things, like using special glues to glue those fossils back together, and even using burlap dipped in plaster to build almost cradles and casts around them to protect them from a long, long time in our collections. So, a fossil preparator has to be really skilled. Good night.
So now that you kind of understand what exactly a fossil preparator is and the certain tools that we use, the question I get asked next is usually, "Hey Hillary, how exactly did you get started in this field?" And that's a very good question. Well, usually when I'm asked that question, I start by saying, "Hey, first of all, do well in school and get a degree in the natural sciences." A natural science degree is usually one in either geology or biology, like I did. I have a degree in biology, which is the study of life. Ooh, pachycephalosaurs! Super cool! Now, I think, besides getting a degree and doing well in school, there's another aspect of paleontology that not everyone fully knows about. And that's something that I did in my career. What is that, would you say? Well, it's get experience in the field! Woohoo! How exactly did I get that experience? In fact, did you know that I actually started my career as a volunteer for 6 years? And through volunteering, that's where I learned how to use all the different tools, how to use and work with fossils, and how even to go on a dig and find bones of my own. Pretty cool, huh? Wow.
A good number of fossil preparators actually get their start by volunteering first, and then they get to go in the field as a career. Now, if you're interested in being a fossil preparator, I definitely recommend that if you're over the age of 18 and have a museum near you, to check it out, see if there's a paleontology program, and see if you can possibly volunteer. In fact, a lot of the people that work at the Perot Museum with me are actually volunteers themselves. How great is that? Hey Google, play.
Everyone, I hope you all enjoyed spending some time in my apartment with me and learning about what a fossil preparator is, what different types of tools and techniques that we use, and even how you can get involved with the museum through a volunteering program. Remember, stay safe, respect social distancing rules, and we'll get through this together, okay? If you have any questions, don't hesitate to message or email the museum, and enjoy the rest of Paleo Week. Bye!
Come here, buddy. Hi. No, don't collapse. Okay. Ooh.
Oh no! Dogs! I'm never working with animals again in my career.